The film festival fireworks are about to begin. Stay tuned.
How you doing?
Hey, man.
And welcome to our special coverage of the 44th annual Seattle International Film Festival. I'm Nancy Guppy here in McCall Hall for the opening night festivities and the opening night film, The Bookshop. Okay, here's the plan. We're gonna chat up filmmakers and stars on the glorious red carpet.
How are you, sweetie?
Celebrate unique Northwest fashion. Rifle through bags of VIP swag. And most importantly, highlight the festival films that you won't wanna miss. Is it magic hair?
Yeah.
It's a little bit sweaty. So strap yourself in and buckle up tight. It's gonna be a wild and zany ride. Hi. Sarah, great to see you.
Great to meet you.
So the name of the film is?
Afghan Cycles.
Okay, and tell us about the film.
The film is about women riding bicycles in Afghanistan, and we explore the freedom and independence that these young women feel when they're on a bicycle.
So we
explore that in the film of what the stakes are, and as time goes on and the country gets more dangerous again, we really see firsthand what that does for the girls.
And where are some of the women now? How are they?
Most of them are still in Afghanistan, but a few have actually left the country and are in different parts of Europe, pursuing their cycling dreams and trying to stay safe. Yeah.
Well, for hanging in there and doing a great film, and it's an important subject.
Thank you.
And it's great that it's going to get out into the world and here at SIFF.
Yeah.
Thrilling.
Oh, so. Thank you. I'm so proud to be here. I'm a Seattle girl, so this is
a
dream come true. All right. Thank you so much.
Great.
Yeah.
Have fun.
Thank you.
Enjoy it. Thank you.
How are you doing back there?
I'm doing good.
Hey, Dad. Not much to report. The news said we were scaling back troops. Do you think you'll be able to come home for good soon? I miss you a lot. Sadie.
Beautiful. You look very 60s hipster.
I was going 60s.
Getting nice and close. Getting close. Hi.
This is T. Denard. He plays Zeke in the film, and you probably know Sophia.
I'm great. Nice to see you. Hi, Sophia. Nice to see you. Okay, get nice and close.
Okay,
the film is called Sadie. Of course, you play Sadie. Tell us the story which you wrote and directed.
Okay,
Megan Griffiths.
Hi, everybody. So Sadie is about a young girl who is living at home with her mom while her dad is serving repeated tours of duty overseas. She idolizes him, wants him to come home. The mom, on the other hand, played by Melanie Lynskey, has gotten a little tired of waiting and decides to move on and start dating someone new. So Sadie decides to become the soldier on the home front and do battle against this new intruder, whatever at the cost.
We're kids, Francis. Nobody cares what we do.
I wanted to comment on the way that I think we're imprinting children with the idea that violence is a way to solve problems. And so I just wanted to write something that contributed to that conversation around youth and violence.
How did you guys find each other? How did you get this part?
Okay, Megan and I we clicked right away.
Did
like,
you?
Yeah, but it's really important for me to be working with someone who treats me as their equal, not like their kid that they're, you know, is on set. And Megan and I feel like we're collaborators, and I love that.
Okay, you, T. Okay, so tell me about your part.
Well, I actually got typecast. They were looking for a grumpy old man, and that's how I got cast. I was grumpy in auditioning.
You are such a SIFF stalwart. Everyone loves you here. I mean, so many of your films have been here.
I mean, it's the best festival, so you got to come back every year.
You got to come back every year.
How else am I going to get my badge and see all these other great movies? You know, I got to make movies.
But SIFF needs you. So thank you guys so much. Enjoy tonight and enjoy the screening of your film. Yeah, I'm going to be watching for more of you and you. Bye, Grumpy.
Okay.
Grumpy old man. The nicest grumpy old man I know. Are you looking at this gorgeous? I have to look. Come here. Seriously. You look fantastic. fantastic.
Thank you so much.
What are you wearing? Who are you wearing?
Oh man, what am I wearing? I think I'm making it look fancier than it actually is.
Oh, it looks so beautiful with your shoe.
Okay, thank
will
you.
You do, will you do a little move? A little
absolutely,
twirl? Okay,
absolutely.
Do it. Do whatever you want to do. Work it. Yeah. Yes. See? You're a lucky man. You are a lucky, lucky man. Have a great night.
Birthday's night, so we're celebrating
him. Oh, happy birthday. You look cute too, by the way.
You know what? It's because of her.
Well, exactly. She's shining on you.
Exactly.
She's shining on you. Bye, you guys.
Thank you
have
so
a good one. All right, I spot some SIFF royalty.
Oh,
hello!
How are you?
I'm great. Beth Barrett, Artistic Director of SIFF. This is like your first year on that specific job, right?
Yes.
And how
yes,
are you
the
feeling?
Interim is gone.
The interim is gone. It's solid. It's real.
We're all set.
And how are you feeling
about
44?
Yeah? I'm really excited about this year. 433 films, 90 countries.
Oh my God.
43% directed by women.
43%?
43% for our films.
Hi. Five, girl.
Yeah.
Okay, so, and by the way, this is looking rather sharp.
Birthday bow tie.
Oh, is it? So the dots with the dots.
Yeah, I know.
All right, so
rocking it.
We always say to you, give us a list of some films that our audience has to see.
Yes.
And then we force you to pick two.
Yes.
And that's mean, but you do a great job. So what do you have for us?
Ooh, it's always such a hard choice.
I
two
know.
Out of 433.
I know. Like I said, we're mean.
Morgan Neville's new film, his new documentary, Won't You Be My Neighbor, about the beloved Fred Rogers.
Oh my God.
I want to tell you something.
What would you like to
tell me? I like you.
I like you, my dear.
Every person who has seen it, even my jaded director, Vince, cried at the trailer. It's unbelievable. It's beautiful.
Well, because we all grew up with him, and we all grew up feeling like he loves us.
Yes, for real.
For real.
The greatest thing that we can do is to help somebody know that they're loved and capable of loving.
Saint, but in most human sort of way.
Exactly,
yeah,
very accessible.
I'm super excited about that. And that will also have a run after the film festival,
will.
Right?
It will, we're bringing it back to SIFF Cinema in the summertime.
Okay, now second.
Second is, let's go with Eighth Grade.
Eighth Grade, oh my God.
And it is a cringe-inducing film because it is literally the final week of this young girl's eighth grade experience.
Oh gosh.
Said one more week of eighth grade, right?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
Yeah, huh?
And I was that kind of nerdy, really kind of dorky.
Uh-huh.
Like, don't say that to that girl.
Wait, I like your shirt a lot. It's like so cool. What?
Oh, you're gonna
you're
say
such
that.
A goofball. Oh God.
But she is so beautiful inside. She's just this gorgeous, gorgeous girl who is gonna be an amazing woman and believes in herself so deeply that it just shines.
Just grab my phone, how to charge you.
Yeah, I mean sometimes I charge it too. But my phone.
That actress looks just
Elsie
great.
Fisher. She was 13, just finishing eighth grade when she shot it. And it's amazing that she could just pull on that so quickly.
Oh man, it just comes right out. Well, so great to see you.
It's
congratulations
great to see you
on 44 years of SIFF. It's gonna be an awesome year.
Thank you.
Beth Barrett, everybody. Oh, should we do It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. A beautiful day for a neighbor. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? Okay, so get in here.
Yeah.
The name of the movie,
Takes an Island.
It Takes an Island. Tell us what the film is about.
Well, we wanted to do a film that captured what it was like to actually live on an island and what the community is like. Which is Orcas Island up in the San Juans.
I'm Kyle Litch. This is my brother, Tashi.
Tashi got into film, and it's like, well, what really captures the idea of the culture of a community, of an island? And it was right in front of us with Tashi and his brother, Kai, and how ever since they were little kids, the island has basically raised them, as his parents have done to other kids.
Yeah.
It's wonderfully gratifying, I mean, to see them hold their own, to stand on their own 2 feet and play it. A sophisticated, complicated tune, play it accurately, very well, play it perfectly, really. Whether I taught them that tune or not, it doesn't matter. Just to see them mature as musicians is really satisfying.
They have been tutored and mentored in everything they've done, by world-class musicians, and now they are a band called Brograss that plays all over the country.
Yeah, Brograss, as in bros, bros, right? So how old are you now?
I'm 16.
And how old is your brother?
He's 14.
So how many years was the filming going on? How old were you when it started?
He was 15 when we started. I was 28. So he's aged better with the pressures of filmmaking.
Yeah, I know. Well, you're just spectacular. And give my best to your brother as well. And the film is charming. And it certainly captures the spirit of Orcas and just the spirit of a community caring about each other. Seriously, I really want to move there. But I want waterfront, and I want it to be around $200,000.
Oh, okay.
Can you work that
out? As long as people have dreams like that, we don't have to worry about overcrowding. So.
Okay. Dang it! Well, thanks, you guys. All right, really you. Nice to talk to you. Have fun. I'm great. Nice to see you, too. So tell me about the film.
Mandy is a story about an Indian teenager.
I did henna once at the District Street Fair.
Shut up. You know how to henna?
I watched a few YouTube videos.
It's about falling in love for the first time, discovering who you are as you fall in love.
I came up with my own design. Here, I'll show you. You start with rings, and then you make a tree with leaves, then flowers.
So tradition clashes a little bit with where the heart wants to go.
And that's it. That's my design.
Was that hard to kind of show it to the community?
Mostly the response has been extremely positive.
Yeah.
But, you know, there's always work to be done.
Well, and that's the point
the
of art,
part.
Right?
Is that's
to kind of cut
part.
Through.
Absolutely.
So how do you feel about it?
I feel great about it. Yeah. I thought it was a really tender and sweet story about two people connecting, you know, so I thought it was a joyous thing. Yeah.
Well, congratulations to you.
Thank you so much.
And by the way, who are you wearing?
I am wearing a South Indian sari. It's called a kanjivaram.
Say it again.
Kanjivaram.
Kanjivaram. Okay, give us a little. There you go. Oh, yeah. Woo, 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 woo. Congratulations, you guys.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Have a good time. Come hither, young men. Wow. And look at you. Well, you look fantastic. Say, what's your name?
Brendan.
Brendan.
And John.
Okay. So, who were you wearing?
Armani and Gucci.
Really?
Gucci.
That's like really nice stuff, you guys. How about this old dude?
Oh, this was a gift that was given, you know, by a special person, so.
Nice.
Yeah.
Look at the shoes. Did you see the shoes?
The shoes, yeah.
Oh, good Lord. Oh, they're both kind of sparkly. Yeah. Do you want to do a little bit of a turn, a little twirl, a little vamp?
Sure, yeah.
Okay, to kind of move it sexy, a little sexy. People, get nice and close. So, hello, your
Hi.
Name?
Angela DeMarco.
David Hogan.
And the film?
The film is Always.
We need to talk.
Talk about what?
You know about what.
We lost our son a year and a half ago, Caleb. He went into early labor is what
you did.
Happened.
So you carried almost full term, close to full term.
Not full, but close. Past the danger zone, so they
supposedly,
say.
Yeah.
And I asked David then, too, do you mind if I go public? And when we did that, this was our third loss. And hundreds of people, men, women, the partners, the mothers who carried and lost, reached out. Hundreds. And I realized after we made the film that this could help continue the story of us sharing grief and not feeling that we as mothers have to hide, that we are less than, and for the partners who stand
absolutely.
By us.
Just let me help you.
You can't help me.
You know, just get closer to people because of something that was very, very tragic and hard, which I think is a beautiful way of dealing with grief, is sharing it and
rather
then
than pulling it.
Well,
Right. You've done a great service to the community, to the world, and you're putting a beautiful piece of art out into the world too. So it's an amazing, amazing piece of work, and SIFF is lucky to have you. Yeah, thank you, you guys. Thank you so much. Yeah, you look beautiful, by the way. You're lucky. You're both lucky. Take care. Tell me about, you composed the music. Okay. By the way, it's a really beautiful, magical film. So tell me about composing the music for
it. So the movie starts very happy, two lovers, yes. Everything going very well. Yes. Kind of paint the picture with the projections. And so when he came to me with that idea, it's like, I want something similar to the Up soundtrack. And so that's what I started with. And then he told me about how it really turns and gets pretty dismal towards the end. And so the music, I added some cello. I added some elements that really brought out that sadness. And
the loneliness, the what could have been, the loss, the not taking advantage of something. Yeah,
absolutely.
Right. Well, you did beautiful work, and my God, so audio is so important. Music and sound, it can make or break. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
so
that's what I'm trying to get
well
into.
Well done.
Eventually.
Well, I think you're off to a good start.
I think so too.
Good grief, you're into it. You're not
so
getting into it. You're into it. Well, you look great, you guys.
Thank
have
you
a fun
so much
time
so much
tonight,
thank
and
you.
Congratulations on the movie.
Thank you.
Yeah, yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. It's a neighborly day for this beauty, Wood. A neighborly day for the beauty. Would you be mine?
Mm-hmm.
Could you be mine? All right, Vlada, I'm Nancy. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
So get in here, girl.
All right, well, Chad, too.
Chad, all of you, come on in. Get in close. Get in close. Lulu.
Hi.
Hi, Chad.
Hello.
Nice to see you. So what did you do with the film?
I'm a producer,
okay.
And I did the sound and the music.
Excellent. You, shot.
I'm a director of photography.
Yeah, excellent. And you, of course.
I'm the director, producer, writer, editor.
Yeah. So tell us the story of your film, and the title and story.
So The Most Dangerous Year is a film about our fight in Washington State in 2016 against anti-transgender legislation.
Trans women are women too!
And it's told from the perspective of a small group of families with transgender children.
How did you find the young girl that you focused on?
Well, there's one young girl I focused on who's my daughter.
Which is amazing.
I want to be a singer, an artist, photographer, fashion designer.
Was it hard as a parent to accept your child being transgender at such a young age? Was it a hard thing to not try to shape that?
Well, initially, when you don't know much about it, it is difficult. It's scary. It's a shock. But once you learn something about it and you realize that a person is born transgender.
Being transgender is not related to mental illness. It's no different than inheriting brown eyes or left-handedness.
She didn't pick this. This wasn't a choice. You know, it's not contagious.
All children know their gender by the time they're about 3 or 4 years old. That's how gender develops. And so once you know that information, it's not hard. In fact, you're actually thankful that you figured it out so early so that they don't have to live in fear and pain any longer than they need to.
Congratulations to all of you guys. Thanks so much. Have fun tonight. And have fun on your film screens.
Thank you.
Yeah. Take it in.
Thank you.
Take it in. Bye, love. I love the stripes.
Thanks.
I'm a stripe girl. Okay, so your name?
Maisa. Maisa Plant Graham.
Now this is, the name of the film?
Impeccable.
Okay, tell me about the person. Now how do you say her name?
Her name is Pekka.
Pekka.
She is a nail artist. She's incredible.
My art is very unapologetic because I feel that it is self-expression to its fullest.
What she can do on the canvas of one fingernail is just really unfathomable.
It's an investment, honestly. It is just like a piece of art that you put on your wall, but it is on your nails. The possibilities are endless.
And how did you find her?
I mean, Instagram.
Well, there
nail
you have
artist.
It.
She was the first one that came up. She's got an insane following.
Well,
know about Pekka. Find her. Follow her. Support her.
How does one function in the world on a day-to-day basis with those kind of fingernails? You know what I'm saying?
Pekka says it's a lifestyle. I am a short nail girl, so
me
I wouldn't
too.
Know about it. But
yeah,
she
show,
says it's
ours. Look at
fully
ours, yeah.
A lifestyle.
Yeah, yeah.
She says it's a lifestyle. You have to learn how to function. You know.
She basically says, and you can.
You can.
You
want to.
Absolutely, absolutely, William.
Well, congratulations
on
the movie
and
how fun that it's going to be. It's SIFF.
So excited.
Right on. Is that a big deal?
It's a huge deal.
Right on.
So excited.
Right.
Have a good
thanks
night.
For talking to me. Bye.
My name is Lael Rogers, and my film is I See Through You.
So tell us about the film.
So I See Through You is a short film that's a 1970s period piece sci-fi about beauty standards and evolving relationships through a few decades.
You have a little bit of a period thing going on now with your look, right?
I do. I got this dress from one of my wardrobe assistants, I figured I might as well wear it.
Oh, it looks great with the eyeliner and everything. So tell me about why did you want to make this particular story?
This particular story, I'm a huge sci-fi fan. I feel like sci-fi is generally a male-dominated genre, and I don't get to see a lot of stories that really resonate with me. So I wrote this and got really excited about it, and somehow it just happened.
I'm assuming it was not super high budget?
No.
So you're going to be really creative with that, right?
A low budget period piece sci-fi genre.
Good for you.
Just throw some children and dogs in there and it's the most difficult thing you've ever made.
Oh my God.
I know.
I have always wanted to have a neighbor just like you. I've always wanted to live in a neighborhood with you. So we're leaving the outdoor red carpet and we're gonna head upstairs to where the fun is. Come on. Hi. Strike a pose. Strike it.
I'm looking forward to Automata.
When the spell breaks, I know that you will leave me and I can't take the chance.
It's a series and has one of my favorite actors, Basil Harris, in it.
I'm done thinking that your love might help me to survive. Cause I know that your good night is your good.
Okay, Anne, do it, baby. Yeah! Woo! And back at it. Nail it, sweetie. Oh, yeah.
I'd say my favorite film this year, which is not like the best film, but it's a film that really caught my attention, is called The African Storm. And basically, it's set in a fictional African country. And so it reminded me a lot of Wakanda in the Black Panther. You have to see it to see this connection. So I recommend everybody check it out.
And go. Here's one more film with a Northwest connection that you will not want to miss.
Something really profound just happened to me, man. I don't
expect you. That's really funny. It's you.
I draw these for a living, but people get mad at me because of the subject matter.
It's offensive. After you've
caused. We all have led in our non-sober periods somewhat chaotic lives. Then again.
You're not to blame. You're a very special person.
You are such a pain in the ass, John.
You're right on schedule, sweetheart, and I'm glad you're here.
Hey, it's a fellow artist. Check this out. I'm not trying to sell you anything. I just want you to look at... They published my cartoon, you...
Okay, well, this is Sarah Wilkie, and Sarah is the executive director of SIFF, which is a big deal. And this is a marker of your first anniversary in this position. So I think ching ching to that. Ching ching. All right, so I asked you to come up with a few things. Obviously, everything is film related, but a few things that people might want to know about that are kind of special events or kind of special programs, whatever.
Yeah, sure. I think one of the things that I'm most excited about, last night we just had a launch of what we're calling the VR Zone at Pacific Place.
Which is virtual reality zone. Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah.
And this is the third year that we've done content like this. It's basically, artists are working in all kinds of different ways now. So for us, it's important, if we're going to be a relevant film festival, we got to meet the artists where they're working.
Yeah.
We've kind of converted in one of the entire storefronts downstairs in Pacific Place.
Oh.
There's pieces that, you know, you're watching the film and you've been immersed yourself in it, and then there's things where you're picking up snowballs and getting in a snowball fight, like literally picking up the snowballs and throwing
that's
up, but they're virtual.
So weird.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Wow.
I'm not very good at that, by the way. But and there's some that are even more poignant where you're sitting there and you're pulling together people's stories who've been there before you. It's just worth checking out.
Oh,
it's
yeah.
Quite
well, a completely different experience.
Completely different
from
experience.
From sitting in a theater, yeah. In a seat, looking at a screen.
Yeah,
right?
Completely different experience. And it shows you, you know, film's the ultimate storytelling media. This shows you the new way that you can add all these layers of empathy and involvement and just get a little deeper around that story.
Right, right.
So,
right.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
So we do the thing where you intertwine,
oh,
and then
yeah.
And this is our SIFF little SIFF. Yeah.
That's the way they do it.
That
in Hollywood,
is
I think.
That is the way they do it in Hollywood. That was a Hollywood moment. Well, the opening night film has begun. SIFF 2018 is officially launched, and now it is time for you to plan your SIFF experience, and it's really easy to do. You pick up one of these little SIFF guides, or you can go online to SIFF.net, look through the over 400 films, pick a bunch, or just a few, and join your fellow movie lovers in this 25-day cinematic extravaganza. So, thanks for watching, and we'll see you at the movies.
It was just a quiet, ordinary night. Until she got one notification that helped her escape the couch to an enchanting world of magic, where she met a friend of a friend. His name was,
Chris, right?
Allie!
Yeah!
They LMFAO. They seriously freaked. And they couldn't hold back the tears.
Gosling, you did it again.
As they became ultra mega cine friends. The Seattle International Film Festival. Starring you.
So this is all the VIP swag bags of stuff that the important people get. So I always think it's important to kind of see what they're getting, make sure it's okay. Like, oh my God, chocolate vanilla swirl. Oh my God, see, I love something like this. It's cookies. So it looks like a cookie with a chocolate. That's right. Excellent. Oh my God. Okay, wait, caramel corn. I love caramel corn. I love it. It's like Cracker Jacks. There is no prize, but. I like that sweet, savory kind of deal. Excellent. What have we got? Whatever, a water bottle, who cares about that? Oh, see, this is always, touchdown. Let's just call it a touchdown. It's Tito's vodka. And I think, want to make sure it's not like a prop, like just water, so. Vodka. There's something else in there. Oh, see, now this stuff, bark thin snacking chocolate. I like that. See, pumpkin seed. Why are these so hard to? Okay, hold on. You know what? I'm just gonna go back. I think before I open that, I'm gonna just have another sip of the vodka. It goes down so smooth, and that might not be a good sign of kind of who I am as a person, but whatever. You know, I'm old now, and I am what I am, right? Oh, I'm so annoyed with this. I'm going back to the crackers. Yeah, I'm gonna put a cracker right here. And let's just top it off with just one more little swig. It's truly delicious.
So let's make the most of this beautiful day. Since we're together, we might as well say, would you be mine? Could you be mine? Won't you be my neighbor? Won't you please? Won't you please, please won't you be my neighbor? Hi, neighbor.
That's Barrett.
Thanks, sweetie.